Now that IDEA knows which lines to import, we need to tell it how to slice up those lines into the individual fields by defining the field anchors. At the beginning of the anchor line, click and hold the mouse button and drag it to the end of the pin field. The field details pane opens up. We need to give the field a name, pin, and we can adjust other settings like field type. IDEA automatically detects that this is a numeric field. However, this field should actually be designated as a character field. We do not expect to do any mathematical analysis on the pin. And if any pins start with leading zeros, those zeros would be dropped in a numeric field. Change the field type to character. Sometimes it can be tricky to correctly select the position of the field anchors. If you need to adjust the field anchors, put your cursor on the edge of the field anchor and use the double arrows to adjust it. Another option is to use the width and offset settings in field details. The offset is where the field starts, and the width is how long the field is. Let's define more fields. Next, I'll define the employee class field, which IDEA recognizes as a character field. Next, I'll select the date and name the field date. The field type is currently set to character. To change this to a date field, make sure that the field anchor was selected accurately. If there are any additional spaces before or after the date in the field anchor, this will cause problems for date fields. From the type dropdown, select date. You must enter a mask to tell IDEA how to parse the date. You won't be able to do anything else until you either enter the date mask or you change the field type back to a character field. This is often a source of confusion for those new to Report Reader, as they will see this error and not know how to get past it. The mask tells IDEA how the date is formatted in the data, which in this case is day-day, month-month, year-year-year-year for a two-digit date, a two-digit month, a four-digit year, separated by slashes. Next, let's define the amount field. The sample line has a smaller amount than some of the other lines, so we need our amount field to be wide enough to include all of the lines in the file. Name this field amount. The numeric type and two decimal places was correctly determined by IDEA. Define the field anchors for the last four fields, ensuring that the field is long enough to include the data, not just in the sample line, but for the other lines we are importing. Click the Save Layer button to save the base layer we created. Once the layer is saved, we can preview the data to see what it would look like when imported into IDEA. Click the Preview Database button. We still have more work to do, so close the preview window.